to this service, celebration of a life well lived, and certainly a life well loved. It's great to have you here today. I'm Pastor Rolf Olson, Richfield Lutheran. I was Hilda's pastor for 3 years, and we had a great time together. Well, imagine. Am I speaking loud enough? Should I talk louder like this? Hey, thank you. No point in flapping my lips if you can't hear me, so I'll do my best. Okay, we're in good shape. Oh, there we go. Just turn the dial up. That's even better. Okay. Again, thank you for coming. As part of the service, there will be a chance a little bit later, if you have a memory or two to share, we'll invite you to come forward and do that. The Norwegian Glee Club was not able to be here today, so we'll have a little more time for sharing the memories. So we'll invite you to do that, and a couple of family members do that as well. Our opening hymn, it's Swedish, but it's close to Norwegian. Show me what I have to God. How do you say it's Norwegian? It's Scandinavian, so we're all covered. Okay, Children of the Heavenly Father.
Knows Hilda in a unique way. We are the threads of her life, She affected all of our lives deeply. She was our mother. She was our grandmother. She was our sister, our auntie, our friend, our neighbor, our co-worker, our caregiver, and our care receiver. She affected us in countless ways, large and small. Hilda affected each of us through her attitudes, her personality, her words, and her deeds. I'm convinced that her positive influences on each of us form the jewels in her heavenly crown. The Bible promises the crown and the jewels as rewards for God's good and faithful servants, of which Hilda was certainly one. Each of you may reflect on what Hilda means to you in your life and how she shaped you to be the person you are today. I see Mother's jewel as a star with the points marking her defining characteristics and her influence on me. 3 points of the star are Hilda's bedrock values: faith, family, and friends. 3 other points are Hilda's unique personality and characteristics. She was a fighter, she was forthright, and she was fun-loving. I'd like to speak just a little bit more about each aspect. Faith. You know, I have a host of childhood memories that include Hilda singing along with Christian radio as she refinished the woodwork in the house. There were a lot of church programs, a lot of dinners at Diamond Lake Lutheran Church where we were all confirmed. We have a lot of memories of growing up Lutheran, just like the book. I had memories of Hilda following her thirst for the word and finding it at Grace Church, at Wooddale Church, and at Edgewater Baptist Churches, and ultimately her last 3 years, her homecoming at Ridgefield Lutheran Church, and her joy in her new church family there. Hilda demonstrated her faith, and she shared her faith through daily devotions and scripture. Mother made a faith journey as a missionary to Trinidad when she was in her late 70s. Mother gave to the causes where the Spirit led. She always said that the more she gave, the more God gave back to her. Hilda was always concerned about her family and her friends, and she wanted the assurance that they find the security and solace of faith in God. At the end of her life, Mother was secure in her faith and the presence of her Lord and Savior, even though she did not yet want to leave her family. Family was the center of her joy. She loved being with her children, her grandchildren, and she wanted to be with them and talk with them. She talked with them about serious things, about fun things, ordinary things. She just wanted to be with them. The fellowship of the family was really essential to her health and well-being. I know I talked with her at least once and frequently twice a day. She talked about all of us children as her chicks that she liked to gather around her. I think that came from her farming background. She was concerned about her family's needs more than her own needs. Personally, I know that she worried about me. She often told me what to do. She listened unswervingly as the cheerleader in my corner, and ultimately, she was the most faithful mother I could hope to be like. In December in the hospital, she didn't want to leave us. She cried at the thought of not being with us at the holidays or special family events. But we can be comforted by the knowledge that her spirit is always with us. She's just too influential to fade away. Friends were so vital to Hilda. She had a huge network of friends from church, from work, from the neighborhood, from her early years in Minneapolis. These long-term faithful friends supported her in countless ways that I can only imagine. She received more birthday cards and Christmas cards than anyone else I know.
Amen.
In her later years, her phone rang constantly from friends checking up on her and staying in touch. Hilda loved going to parties, events, activities with her friends. She traveled around the country and even overseas to visit friends. She kept busier than many people a lot younger. What was the secret to her many friendships? In the hospital, when she could still speak clearly, I remarked to her that I hoped I would have as many friends as she did when and if I lived to be 92. And her response, you have to gather friends like flowers. Hilda treasured and cherished the uniqueness of each friend. Thank you for being her friend. Now, Mother was a fighter in the very best sense of the word. She fought against negative forces with positive energy. She constantly maintained an upbeat and can-do attitude to overcome a number of the challenges she faced. Her health, she recovered against all odds from episodes of major surgeries, stroke, severe burns, and fractures. She always said that she had to keep on keeping on. And oftentimes she said in Norwegian, which means the willpower carries the whole load. Her strength of character to fight the good fight carried her also through the pain of loss of her parents, her husband, close friends, and other family members. At the end of her life, her fighting spirit remained strong, but her body couldn't keep up. Ultimately, she had the strength to let God carry the fight for her. Now, Hilda was very forthright. I suppose you could say that she always said what she thought. Plain speaking was her style. Sometimes this resulted in some exasperating moments, and sometimes in some pretty funny, inadvertently funny moments. But you always knew exactly what she thought at any particular moment in time. And she just had too much world experience not to share her view with others. I will miss that. Mother was fun-loving. She loved getting out and doing things. From her youth, she spoke of the down-home fun, the parlor dances, the barn dances, the socials that formed the fabric in small-town life. Even though she was busy with four kids growing up, she found time to have fun with the neighborhood and with church social groups. And I remember many of those circles hosted at our house. Mother and Dad went on many trips when he retired. They had great fun meeting people, going to new places, and meeting new friends and making new friends. Mother enjoyed so many of the activities at Ridgefield Church. As you can tell from the photos on the board, she loved the parties, she loved everything there. One of the highlights of her last year was the trip that we took to Duluth to see the King and Queen of Norway. That was the most special thing in her fall for her. She was so happy to be there. She was interviewed by the Norwegian and the Duluth press, and she was so pleased to have her picture in the paper. In the last few years of her life, each of us children had an opportunity to go on special trips with her. She went to Arizona with Sharon, she went to Hawaii with me, she went to Florida with Stan, and she went to Spring Grove with Steve. So we each had special time with her. As you already know, Mother was an original. She was who she was. I love her for the uniqueness of her character. I appreciate the values she instilled and the steady influence on my life. Although I miss her already, I know she's always with us, and we have, of course, the promise of eternal life. And I will see her again, crowned with her heavenly jewel crown.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Marilyn Martin, and I met Hilda through Cheryl. In 1969, Cheryl and I moved to Donaldson's, and Cheryl was so excited because her sister was getting married in a few months. And then I quickly became friends with Hilda and the rest of the family. And I really valued Hilda because my mother had died We were different in a lot of ways. She was a Norwegian Lutheran, and I'm an Irish Catholic. But I still felt like I was her daughter. And like some daughters, we disagreed, we argued, but there was always love. That never abated. And I was fortunate to see Hilda the day she died. I just kind of had a feeling. I had visited her often, but I went that day. It was January 25th, and she was a little restless. So what I did was I took her hands, and I gave her a massage. Now, my hands are not like Hilda's. My hands are soft, and because I didn't do hard work like Hilda did. And I remember once after my mother died, a cousin who did not like my mother at all said to me, "Oh, you have your mother's hands. Your mother had holy hands, too." I'll never forget that. But anyway, Hilda had strong hands. And when I was massaging her hands, I told her all that those hands had done. And I'll tell you some of those things right now. Hilda, she grew up on the farm, and at an early age, she learned to pray, and she read her Bible. She also prayed hard for the younger sister or brother, and she got it in Helen. She also fed the chickens, and I think maybe that's why Hilda never appreciated a chicken dinner. Whenever we go out to eat at the country buffet or a nice place, she'd say, "No, I'm chicken, I'm not eating chicken." So that was kind of a little joke with Hilda and I. But I said to her, "Hilda, these hands did a lot in 92 years. You started young and prayed, you read your Bible, you also fed the chickens." And Hilda was smart. She went to school to be a nurse, and of course, nurses have caring, loving hands. And Hilda was smart too. She was very good in chemistry, and she also tutored some of the other students in chemistry. I wish I would have known this. I could have used her help in college, but I didn't know it then. And she tutored her future sister-in-law, Margaret. So after she became a nurse, she got married, and those beautiful, caring, strong hands raised four children and six grandchildren, all who loved Hilda dearly. And with those hands, she sewed, she created wonderful birthday parties. I remember when Leslie was little, remember those Barbie doll cakes you'd see? Hilda would create those. She'd have a Barbie in the middle, and then she'd make a cake around it and decorate it so beautifully. A lot of mothers wouldn't do that. I'm not a mother, and I had no idea. I would just put whipped cream around Barbie and hope that it would stay until the party. To a Norwegian restaurant, and we celebrate the March birthdays. Cheryl's, my dad's, and Margaret, her sister-in-law. And we had so much fun. You know what Hilda did? We had this whole room to ourselves, and a lot of you were there. I'd say roughly 20 of us. And she made special angel food cake for the three birthday people. And she also brought in beautiful daffodils. And she set this on the lawn table. It was just gorgeous. I mean, here she planned this whole luncheon, but she also was thoughtful enough to bring flowers at each birthday person. Oh, I wish I would have been a March birthday, but my dad was, so I got part of the cake. And these were homemade angel food cakes that Hilda made and decorated. And in the center, a beautiful vase with daffodils for the three March birthdays to take home. I mean, what memories I have. And Hilda, not only being a good cook, she entered the state fair competition, and she won for her tomatoes and her rolls, and all her rolls were good. So those loving hands also accepted prizes in nursing school for her high grades in chemistry. She was also in the Nurses Honor Society for excellent grades. And she also collected blue ribbons. So those hands not only did a lot of hard work, but they also received appreciation for all and anything she did. Now, as I said earlier, I'm Catholic, Hilda was Lutheran. She got me into Bible study, which I appreciated, because Catholics, we're just starting to learn, maybe you should read a Bible, that's great. So Hilda got me into Bible study, which I really enjoyed. And I always do my homework religiously, because I wasn't that familiar with Bible, you know, the Bible like Hilda was. I get so mad because I get there early and I'd be going over my lesson. Hilda would come in late. She didn't even have to look at the question. She knew the answers. So I want to share something with you. My Bible's a little bit different, but there's a wonderful story in there, and I'm going to change the name a little bit. In the Bible, the Catholic Bible that I have, it's a man, but I'm going to change it to Hilda. There was a holy good woman that talked to God every night. And they would take each other's hand and they'd walk. But one night they walked a little too far. And Jesus said to Hilda, "You've walked a little too far." She goes, "Oh, I should be going home." And Jesus said, "No, Hilda, you've worked long and hard. You're coming with me." Thank you.
One or two other brief comments. Speak loudly from back there.
I hope so. You have a peculiar expression I just love. She would be, her and Ross would be at our place for Bible study. She and Ross would be at our place for Bible study. She would be explaining something, and Russ would start to add something, and she would say, "Put a cork in it, Russ."
Situation was she was keeping her Cheryl's dogs as well as the birds, and the dogs, she felt like they needed to be fed because they were hungry. I didn't know that her granddaughter was there, and I was saying, you sure? And her granddaughter said, no, I fed 2 hours ago. She said, no,
those dogs are hungry. You know how dogs are. They spend 5 minutes
eating and the rest of the day looking for food. But I didn't want to get in the middle of that, so we reluctantly got some food out, and I left the situation. But Hilda had a love for people as well as pets, and I just cherish her. I'm going to miss her quite a bit because she was a great neighbor and welcomed me with open arms, and we just had some great conversations, and she'll be missed.
Therefore, I tell you, do not worry about your life,
what you will eat or what you will drink, or about your body, what you will wear. Is not life more than food, and the body more than clothing? Look at the birds in the air. They neither sow nor reap nor gather into barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not of more value than they? And can any of you, by worrying, add a single hour to your span of life? Then why do you worry about clothing? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. They neither toil nor spin. Yet I tell you, even Solomon in all his glory was not clothed like one of these. But if God so clothes the grass of the field, which is alive today and tomorrow is thrown into the oven, will he not much more clothe you, you of little faith? Therefore, do not worry, saying, what will we eat, or what will we drink, or what will we wear? For it is the Gentiles who strive for all these things. And indeed, your heavenly Father knows that you need all these things. But strive first for the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well. So do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will bring worries of its own. Today's trouble is enough for today. The word of the Lord.
From the time Hilda Johnson bounded out of Spring Grove, I don't think she ever stopped running. You heard about all that this morning. In his letter to Timothy, St. Paul talked about the fact that he had run the race and kept the faith. He said, I fought the good fight, I finished the race, I have kept the faith. Now there is in store for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will award to me on that day, and not only to me, but also to all who have longed for his appearing. Those are such fitting words for Hilda Johnson as well, aren't they? Hilda didn't just die recently. I think her body just ran out of gas. Hilda the mom, the world traveler, the nature lover, Hilda the small town girl and big city slicker, Hilda the nurse well into her 80s, Hilda politically active, deeply faithful. You know, when Hilda joined Richfield Lutheran 3 years ago, she was by far the oldest new member I had ever received. And I thought, well, lady, this is going to be a short time, but let's make it a good time. And it fit perfectly with her philosophy, too. You know, she said she wanted to burn out, not rust out. And she succeeded. You know, there aren't many who have left such a trail behind them as Hilda has. Married over 50 years, 4 kids, a bunch of grandkids and more. Traveled to China, Europe, Australia, New Zealand, Israel, Haiti, missionary in Trinidad. She just loved to relax. You know that. She told me all about the king and queen coming to Minnesota last fall. Now she went up to Duluth. She was all abuzz with excitement. She had to report to me on everything about that. You see, I'm Norwegian. I'm Rolf Erik Olsen. She loved that about me. But I'm a bad Norwegian. I speak Spanish. I was such a disappointment to go there. Well, Hilda's life spanned her early years in Blackhammer, down by Spring Grove, southeast of Rochester. It's in Minnesota, you know, it's not down there in the hill country. I've heard of Spring Grove. I had never heard of Blackhammer before. But interestingly, when she came to Richfield Lutheran, she met someone else from Spring Grove who was 1 year younger than Hilda. They talked Norwegian to each other. They talked good old days. Well, her lifespan, this childhood, this school in a one-room school, one-room schoolhouse, she fired with horses, and yet now she died in the space age with rockets and travel all over the world. You got to call her mom, you got to call her grandma, you got to call her friend. I got to call her mentor and my dance partner. Hilda and I danced at several church functions. There's a picture of us out there. Wearing a silly outfit. But she would just stand up. I'd have to kind of lift her out of her chair and then she'd run back and forth like this. And then she'd talk about it for a week. You probably heard about it, I certainly did. Well, this is a day that we knew was coming ever closer, as it does for each of us. But you know, we always want to hold off for just a little longer, one more year, one more dance, maybe one more experience together. We get a little greedy about that, I suppose. But it was not to be. And there's a very real sense that awareness of our deaths adds meaning and depth to the days that we do have in this world. With every sore muscle in the morning, with every close call of a friend, with every funeral that we attend, our sensitivity to our human frailty certainly increases. With all that, each day is seen more and more as a gift. Certainly with Hilda, this was especially so these last few years. Hilda stooped over, not as articulate as she once was. Vibrant spirit, but a body that just didn't quite match that spirit. Hilda left a blessing with anyone she encountered. She blessed others because she knew that she was blessed. With wonderful family and friends, certainly. But especially with the Lord, who knew her oh so well, but yet embraced her unconditionally, in spite of those faults. With Hilda, perhaps that sense of blessing is more obvious than with many. She had a great life, you know that. And now it's over. Now we gather to say goodbye. And as we do that, we're forced to address another level of life much more directly. And that realm is the realm of the one who blesses, the one who gives life to each of us, and at its end, the one who promises to take us to his care. As St. Paul approached the end of his life, he looked back at the days behind him as a race. He had run a good race. He was approaching the finish line. And he knew that at its end, another experience awaited him, one that was available only through the judge of that race, and that was certainly Jesus Christ. St. Paul lived a life of faith. He knew that the verdict on him was a good one, and Jesus assured him of that. So Paul couldn't wait to get there. Death held no fear for him. He saw death as a promise, not as a threat. So I consider that for our lives today. How many people deep down run from death? They try to deny its reality in themselves and in our world. Of course, that's silly. There's a story about this that I appreciate. It comes out of the Middle East. It takes place in Iraq. A merchant lived in Baghdad. One day he sent his servant out to the marketplace to get some groceries, to get provisions. But very quickly the servant came running back. He was ashen. He was trembling. And he said, "Master, just now when I was in the marketplace, I was jostled by a woman. And when I looked, I didn't see a woman. I saw a death standing there. And she looked at me and she gave me a threatening gesture. Now please, lend me your horse. I will ride away to Samarra, and there death will not find me." Certainly lent his faithful servant his horse, and the servant sped away across the desert. And then the merchant went down to the marketplace to check it out for himself, and he saw death standing there in the crowd. So he went up to her and he said, "Why did you make a threatening gesture to my servant this morning?" "Well, that wasn't a threatening gesture," said death. "It was only a gesture of surprise. You see, I was astonished to see your servant in Baghdad, because tonight I have an appointment with him in Samarra." There's an appointment for each of us as well. And no amount of running, no amount of denying, no amount of covering up can change that appointment. So in the face of this, how comforting to know, and yet how difficult it is to accept, that what we run from, God can handle quite easily. We don't know what lies on the other side of death. We don't know what Hilda is now privileged to experience. But we do know who it is, who is there. That's enough. It's the same one who spoke to Moses in that burning bush. It's the same one who appeared to those disciples on that first Easter. It's the same one who spoke to St. Paul and gave him the confidence to live and to write as he did. Well, deep in the level levels of existence, beneath the threats of death, and beyond our human comprehension, the power of the resurrected one continues to nurture and to support us in ways far beyond our knowing. So being here today brings all sorts of reactions in us. It stirs up all sorts of feelings. But perhaps mostly this event is a celebration of a life well lived. We've heard plenty about that already. But this gathering also reminds us that one day we too will lay here. And I hope, like with Paul, like with Hilda Johnson, we can respond that we have met the Christ, that we've run the race of faith, that we've lived a full round of experiences in the days that we've had, and that our fears are no more. What God has in store for us, we can't know. But knowing that our God has taken care of our deepest needs frees us to live each remaining day to its fullest. So whether we have 93 years or many less, God has laid out for us each day as a gift. And when those days are gone, God has another gift to present to us. Today we celebrate that gift to Hilda. We celebrate the gift that she was to each of us. And we leave giving thanks for the gifts of God that continue to sustain us. We're going to sing What a Friend We Have in Jesus. In a fit of folly, I said I'd bring my banjo with our musician, Jeff Jameson.
He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, forgiveness of sins, resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Loving God, grant to us who are still in our pilgrimage and who walk as yet by faith, that your Holy Spirit may lead us in holiness and righteousness all our days. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Grant to all who mourn a sure confidence in your loving care, that casting all their sorrow on you, they may know the consolation of your love. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Grant us grace to entrust Hilda to your never-failing love, which sustained her in this life. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, and remember her according to the favor you bear for your people. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray the prayer Jesus taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant, Hilda Johnson. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen. Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen. You may be seated for our closing hymn.
Thank you. Reading from St. Paul's letter to the Romans. None of us lives to himself, and none of us dies to himself. If we live, we live to the Lord, and if we die, we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. And from John chapter 11, I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. In the sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to Almighty God our sister, Hilda Christine Johnson. And we commit her body to its resting place, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. The Lord bless her and keep her. Lord, make his face shine on her and be gracious to her. The Lord look upon her with favor and give her peace. Amen.
Amen.
We pray the prayer Jesus taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. And now may the God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, the great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the everlasting covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in his sight, through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
We go in peace. Amen.